If you're preparing to close your first funding round, odds are good that you're looking at choosing between a convertible note and a SAFE, the simple agreement for future equity. How do you choose? I'll talk about a couple things to think about in today's video. Hi, I'm Steve Morris, and I use this Startup SOS channel to provide practical how-to advice for new entrepreneurs. So if you're trying to choose between a convertible note and a SAFE, I'd suggest you start by checking out our videos on the convertible note and on the simple agreement for future equity, especially the post-money SAFE, that being the most recent version of the SAFE. Once you have a good understanding of the basics of those two instruments, the question is, which is the best fit for you? They are by far the two most common mechanisms used for very early stage funding for a number of reasons we go through in those two videos I mentioned. But which indeed is preferred? Well, they certainly have a lot in common. They're both convertible securities, and as such, they're both a way for an investor to get money to the company with the intent that in the future, it's going to convert to stock. They both can have a discount, but they don't have to. They both can have a valuation cap, but they don't have to. And both of them can be executed with a fairly simple legal agreement that's not going to cost you a lot of legal fees. So those are all things they have in common. They also share a couple of drawbacks in common. One of those drawbacks is dilution visibility. You're never really sure with either a note or a SAFE exactly how much dilution the founding team is going to experience. Now, if you're doing a SAFE and it has a post-money cap, you do know what ownership, minimum ownership, you're going to be guaranteeing to the investors. But depending on what the pre-money value is of the later round that converts that SAFE into stock, their ownership could be significantly higher than that. Likewise, the same situation can happen for a convertible note. You may set a cap on the note, but still, depending on the price of the round that converts the note, the actual amount of stock that the investors can purchase may be considerably higher than you thought. Now, the only way to get around not knowing what your dilution is to do a priced round. And the issue with a priced round, of course, is it's much, much more in the way of legal documents, which means much more legal expense, unless you can agree on a standard set of documents that doesn't involve any adjustment by lawyers. But that is the one way that you really know going into it what dilution you'll experience. Either a note or a SAFE, there's always a little bit of fuzziness as to exactly what the dilution will be. So that's one drawback they have in common. Another drawback they have in common is, in both cases, there can be a cap, and frequently investors will insist on a cap, which means you're stuck with the process of negotiating that cap. Probably a pre-money cap in terms of a note, or it may be a post-value cap in terms of the SAFE. But either way, the challenge is to figure out what your valuation might be in that later round that's going to convert either the note or the SAFE into stock, and try to come up with a cap that, from your point of view, you'd like it to be fairly close to what that later value is, so that your early investors through the note or the SAFE aren't getting a huge increase in the amount of stock they're getting because their cap is so much lower than that later pre-money value. Now, sometimes you can get away with negotiating either a SAFE or a convertible note without a cap. That's a great thing for an entrepreneur to do because it really pushes off the whole valuation question until that later round. It saves you a lot of time and hassle. But sometimes investors insist they really do want a cap, and so you're stuck with negotiating to figure out exactly what that cap might be. So what are the convertible note drawbacks? A big drawback of a convertible note is that it is debt. Now, in some cases, that can cause a problem. One particular case I'm aware of is in the Small Business Innovation Research, or SBIR, grant program, which is a U.S. government program that provides grants, pretty substantial grants, to tech startups. Some of the agencies that participate in that program do not like to see any debt on the balance sheet of the company, not even convertible note debt, even though they're intended to convert to stock, which means they'll come off the debt part of the balance sheet. But some of the agencies, the National Science Foundation being one of them, simply don't like to see debt on the balance sheet. So that's an example where debt can really be a drawback. Another drawback of the convertible note is it has an interest rate. That's not something you're actually paying out of your pocket, but it's adding into the total value of the note, which means when the note converts into stock, the investor is getting that much more stock for the amount in the note because it's accrued all that interest. And a final drawback is it has a due date, and this is a big one. When a note comes due, it's payable. Now, maybe that's 1 year down the road or 2 years or even more, depending on what you negotiate with the investors. But at some point, a note will have a due date. It will come due. And at that point, the default situation is it's due and payable. Well, you typically don't want to pay off a note because you usually don't have the cash to do that. And the whole idea, of course, is that you'll convert to stock before the note comes to its term. But if that doesn't happen, well, then you're in an awkward position of having to negotiate an extension with the investor. And that gives the investor a fair amount of negotiating leverage. So a due date is really something that's kind of a pain for an entrepreneur to deal with. It's something investors often tend to like because it gives them a little more negotiating leverage. So those are some of the drawbacks for the convertible note. Now, how about drawbacks for the SAFE, the Simple Agreement for Future Equity? Well, honestly, there are not a lot of drawbacks from the entrepreneur's point of view. The SAFE has no deadline. It doesn't have a date at which it comes to term and becomes payable. So you don't have that deadline hanging over you. It doesn't have an interest rate, and it's not debt on your balance sheet. So it doesn't have those drawbacks that a convertible note has. The only drawback a SAFE can have, there are some parts of the country where investors are more comfortable investing with a convertible note. And the reason is that it does have things like a term, a deadline when the note becomes due, which gives more negotiating leverage to the investor. The case of a SAFE, if I write you a check under a SAFE and give you some money, then there's no guarantee I will ever get anything back in the way of stock. There's no deadline. It just takes some kind of a price round in the future to convert that investment into stock. But it could be that that never happens. So there's just less protection there from an investor's point of view. Having said that, there are some parts of the country, the Bay Area is one example, where the SAFE is absolutely the standard way of investing in early stage startups. So investors have sort of gotten over a lot of those concerns and are typically ready to use a SAFE. But if you're in a part of the country where investors are a little nervous about a SAFE and would prefer a convertible note, that's worth taking into account. It's always hard enough to close an investment round, and it usually helps to remove any barriers that you can remove. If a SAFE is a barrier because people prefer a convertible note, might be a good idea to consider using the convertible note for your round instead of using a SAFE. So bottom line, I think it's safe to say that for the entrepreneur, the SAFE is usually the preferred way to go. No interest rate, no maturity date, and it is not debt. The SAFE is usually the preferred option, unless, the caveat, the investors prefer the convertible note to the SAFE, which they may well, because interest, maturity date, those are things that they tend to like. So those are some considerations to think about when you're looking at a SAFE versus a convertible note. This video is part of an entire series on startup funding, and there's a link to the series right here. If this was helpful, please click like, share it with other entrepreneurs, and leave a comment or a question. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do that and click the notification bell because we always have more videos coming up for the new entrepreneur. That's a wrap for this time. Thank you very much for watching.